In this module, so this is the last module and fifth module of your electromagnetic theory. So in the last module, fourth module, we have seen that we have studied about electromagnetic waves and how it is getting propagated. And then towards the end, we studied about skin depth, pointing vector. So pointing vector help us to find out the power being transmitted and all. So in this module, we are studying about the transmission line. So how power is being transmitted in the transmission line, or how the waves are being transmitted from the sending end to receiving end. So whatever you're studying here in this fifth module, a continuation of this, you will study in power system one, which is about generation and transmission. So in your next semester, you will be studying a continuation of this. So it is better you understand these things here itself. So it will be very easy for you in your next semester. So now, first of all, let us see what do you mean by a transmission line. So transmission lines are used to direct the propagation of energy. So this is a very simple definition you have. Concept. Transmission lines are used to direct the propagation of energy from source to the load. So the source can be the generating station, or from the substation, or from the substation to the load, from to our houses. So all these places we are using transmission line. So we are studying the very basic thing. So transmission lines are used to direct the propagation of energy from source to the load. So what actually they are doing? Transmission lines. So I'll be writing transmission line like this. So transmission lines convey electromagnetic waves. So transmission lines, they convey electromagnetic waves. So what is an electromagnetic wave? What does that contain? How it is being propagated? What is the power associated with that? All these things we have seen in fourth module. So now we are transmitting these electromagnetic waves by using the transmission line. And then we are studying about the phenomenons happening there, new things we are studying. Okay. So transmission lines, again, some more theoretical things I want to say as an introduction. Transmission lines are commonly used. Transmission lines are commonly used in power distribution. So all these things you know practically. Power distribution at low frequency and in communication lines. So all these are transmission lines only. So we use flexible cable, armored cable, or different types of transmission lines we use. So all these things you study in power system. Now no need to go into that. So this is the very basic thing, and for communication at high frequency. So telephonic lines, you know, communication lines. So all these are all transmission lines, but the type of transmission line that we use differ based on the application. Okay. Okay. Then at low frequencies, the energy loss in the connecting wire is negligible. So we have studied that. Now we have seen that Asar has mentioned about low frequency as well as high frequency. So a small point I want to add: at low frequency, the energy loss in the connecting wire means the transmission line, energy loss is negligible. And then for higher frequencies, the loss can be reduced by using two parallel wires. So higher frequency means losses are high. So now we will see how these loss can be reduced. And so that explains the type of transmission lines. So now we understood what is a transmission line and what does that do. Now let's see the types of transmission lines. Okay. So these are the types of transmission lines. So I will write one by one what it is. So first type is the open wire line. So what does open wire line means? Open wire line means a normal two-wire transmission line. That is, parallel conductors are open to air. What we are seeing outside? Parallel conductors open to air So they are called open wire transmission line. And they are separated by, you have seen that, they are separated by air as the dielectric medium. And they are mounted on electric post, right? So, separated by air as dielectric medium and mounted on post. So you may get a question in A part, what are the different types of transmission lines? So this is the answer. So open wire system, I think it's better I use a different color. So second one, it's all about the cables. So mainly we are talking about underground telephonic cables. So if you have seen a telephonic line being opened, if some maintenance was happening near the telephone lines, if you have been there, you might have seen a telephonic cable. When it is taken outside, it consists of a lot of cables inside. Flexible cables will be there. So fiber optic cables will be there. So that's about underground telephonic cables. Then the third one is coaxial cable. So all these things you might have studied earlier. Okay, coaxial cable, this is very familiar for you, right? Like two conductors. So there will be another cable inside and it will be hollow. So two conductors and the dielectric in between, right? So this is the dielectric in between. And we will have two. So this is the dielectric, right? This is the dielectric and two conductors. This is the conductor one and this is the conductor two. So two conductors and dielectric in between. That is all about coaxial line. Two conductors and dielectric. So these are two types. So three types: open wire line, cables, coaxial line, and the fourth one is what we call wave gates. So this might be a very something new for you. So wave gates, they are actually hollow conducting tubes. So wave gates are hollow conducting tubes. So this is actually a circular wave gate. So if you refer the textbook, you might see rectangular wave gate. So the main thing is it is a hollow conductive tube and it is used for microwave frequency transmission. So this is used for microwave frequency transmission. So the four types of transmission lines are open wire line. So you know what it is. The examples are transmission line, then telephonic lines are also there, open wire lines. So here cables means actually the underground telephonic cables. And then you can also mention a disadvantage of open wire line. Disadvantage of open wire line is that the initial setting cost is very high. You know, setting up a post and then erecting it. So its initial setting cost is very high. High initial setting cost. And then another disadvantage is atmospheric conditions will be affected by atmospheric condition. So this is the disadvantage of an open wire system. Okay, so I have written everything here. Hope it's clear for you. So four types of transmission line: open wire line. So this is the explanation, and we have the disadvantages here. Then cables, coaxial lines, and wave gates. Okay, so cables, coaxial lines, and wave gates. So this much you should write when a question comes, what are the different types of transmission lines?